So, you know, being a composer doesn't mean that the ideas are constantly flowing. Oh, Mozart was like that. You know, Mozart said he composed like a sow goes to the bathroom or something. He had some quote like that. You know, for me, it's not like that. It's not a constant flow of ideas. And sometimes it's a lot of work. And I remember before I made the choice to go to Eastman for grad school, I remember this one day where Mom made lunch for me, and I was at the piano, and I was trying to write some piece because I was going to Eastman at the middle of the semester, and all the students had written these studio orchestra pieces, and I was thinking, I just want to have one song or something kind of underway when I start there. And I was trying to write something, and I was so full of doubt. I was so terrified. And I thought, do I really want the rest of my life to depend on coming up with musical ideas? And I was just filled with this heavy sense of just that I didn't know if I could do it. And I got to Eastman, and I was really in tears a lot the first few weeks because I was comparing myself to everybody and all these amazingly talented people. But then, you know, all of a sudden I started to get into doing my own things and the rush of learning and expressing and getting my music played, and I started to realize it for all its difficulties, there's no joy deeper than creating something, hearing it back and feeling it, that it's, you've created something beyond just the notes on the paper, you know, that this personality comes out of the music and the meeting point of players playing that and everybody bringing it to life. I mean, it's such a privilege to be a musician. It's such a privilege to be part of the musical community that comes together and makes music together. That, you know, it's like, okay, yes, there's points where you really struggle with the motivation, but it's worth it to push through because when you get the reward, it's just, it's really massive. And just one more thing to that end, sometimes the motivation doesn't come from music itself, it comes from other things. It's really important as a musician to lead a rich life, because your music expresses your life. You know, music is not just music. We are not learning music in school so that we can spit out music to people. We're learning the tools of music so that we can express something about life to other people and express it more accurately, more vividly, more powerfully. So, you know, it's just very important that in your effort to be the best musician you can be, you don't forget that being a human and enjoying and all the beautiful things in life and splurging and experiencing, you know, the depth of life, it's very important. But we tend to think if we're not working that we aren't doing. And that's something I always have to remind myself, that right now I'm in a period where I haven't been producing music. But I've been doing a lot of different things in my life that I haven't done before outside of music. And maybe it'll translate into music. And if it doesn't, well, then life is life too. You know, music isn't everything in life. It's the expression of life, so... There's no perfect answer to these questions, you know? It's tough. Music is a tough road, but it's a beautiful road too.